Have you ever tried to make an HTTP request with a body size over 1 megabyte? If you haven't, the result may probably be a 413, content too large. All HTTP servers have some limitation on the request size. Nginx, for example, has a default limit of 1 megabyte. You can increase that limit, but there will be negative effects. Request chunking solves this limitation and other problems, but it can also improve the overall performance of your service. For simplicity, let's say that we want to upload a file, and we want to create a service that once the file is uploaded, it will return an ID generated to identify the file. If our file is small, we can have a single small upload service that takes only the body and returns the ID that identifies the file. Remember that this service will return 413 content too large if the size is over the configured threshold, let's say 1 megabyte. But let's try splitting the file in chunks. Splitting is easy. We define a chunk size, and by dividing the file size by the chunk size, we get the number of full chunks. We must remember that if the file size is not a multiple of the chunk size, we will also have a smaller chunk at the end. To upload these chunks, we need to add some more information. The server must be able to identify that all of the chunks are part of the same upload, right? So we define an upload ID to send along with the chunks to group them together. Remember that from the server point of view, you're not alone. So those IDs must be unique in some way. If your session is authenticated, you just need something that is unique in your session. Otherwise, you need something globally unique. Going back to the extra information that we need. How the server knows which chunk has received and how many chunks will be sent. We can also add the chunk ID, chunk size, and the total file size to the request. In this way, the server will have all the information. Given that, we can start uploading the first chunk. The server receives it and stores it on the side. Since the file is not complete, our service will not return the blob ID, but it will return an accepted state that tells us that the chunk is stored on the side. We upload the second chunk, and the server will store it near the other one, grouping them by the upload ID. Again, we return an accepted state. Same thing for the third chunk. But the fourth chunk will be the last. Given the file length, the server knows it and creates a blob ID and persists the full file. At this point, we can return the 200K or the 201 created with a blob ID to tell the client that the upload is complete. From a code point of view, error checking aside, it is just a straightforward for loop for uploading the full chunks and a special case for the last chunk that may have less data to read. Once everything is uploaded, we should get the blob ID. Cool. But now that we have chunks, can we upload them in parallel? Yes, we can, but we also have to deal with chunks arriving out of order. But on the server side, that is not a problem. We are handling things like before, we collect chunks on the side and we return accepted. Now, chunk 3, which is the last one, is received by the server, but chunk 1 is still missing. The server knows that, because it knows how many chunks are expected. Once chunk 1 is received, every chunk are on the server. We can create a blob ID and persist the file. If we have multiple machines, can we leverage all the instances available? Yes, it is the same thing as the parallel upload. The main difference is that there should be a state store and a chunk storage reachable by every machine. The state store just needs a map with a bitmap of chunks and some information to validate the request, like the chunk size and the file size. Once a chunk is received, a bit at the position of the chunk is set. The operation that will set the last remaining bit will also create the blob ID and persist the file. So, why chunking is great? You can solve the server size limitation, you can parallelize the upload, and even use multiple machines. And if all the requests have more or less the same size, the overall server performance will be better. If you have any question or want to know more, leave a comment below.